This is an idling engine. The car has stopped, but it's still running. It can happen at junctions and traffic lights, but the real problems arise when vehicles are at a standstill, in traffic jams, or outside schools. Idling increases the amount of exhaust fumes in the air, which can lead to harmful pollution. Camden Council are about to issue fines for those who are caught doing this at length.
Currently here in Camden, we fail on one important count of air pollution measures, which is nitrogen dioxide. We are technically compliant on particulate matter, which is the nasty stuff that comes out of the tailpipe and off your brakes and tyres. However, we've always said that particulate matter is really dangerous, and for that reason, we're looking at everything we can do to improve the air quality within the borough. And included within that is going out, speaking to people about engine idling, asking them why they're doing it, talking to them about why it's bad for the environment, and taking enforcement action if they don't comply.
But the big question is, do these fines even work? Some London boroughs have already got the power to fine drivers with idling engines, but they haven't issued many fines so far. In Westminster, they've issued out the most, with 28 in the course of a year. But the City of London can fine people for the last 7 years, and they haven't done so at all. Now, we're here in Kensington and Chelsea, where they've had the power for the longest, for 15 whole years, and yet they've only ever fined one driver. They say it's because they need harsher powers to put in place to fine people with idling engines.
So in addition to wanting to increase the power, increase the sum to over the £40 level at the moment, we also want the power to be able to issue that notice straight away. So that if cars are persistently flouting this and not doing what we ask them to do, and the level of fine will be high enough to be a real deterrent to drivers.
The news of boroughs taking up this initiative has been welcomed by the environmental charity Client Earth, but they believe it's a case of changing people's behaviour rather than laws.
Fines should always be a last resort. Once people are asked to turn their engines off, they turn their engines off. They're not going to be fined for that. It's only if they refuse to turn them off. And I think we just need to make people aware of the dangers of idling and the effects that it has on particularly children near playgrounds, for instance, when they breathe in this harmful air. And I think once people are made aware, they'll turn their engine off.
Camden Council's policy will come into force on the 12th of March, asking drivers to take their foot off the gas whilst moving forward to improve the capital's air quality.